Hello students, today we are going to discuss the next topic of this chapter, that is about the shadows. In this video we are going to discuss how are shadows formed, what are the conditions required for the shadow to be formed, an experiment related to the shadow formation, eclipses and the types of eclipses. So let's begin. Dear students, few days before I have given you an activity based on shadow. And I have told you that we are going to discuss about this activity in the next chapter. So today we are going to discuss about the shadows, that how shadows are formed. For shadow to be formed, what we require a source of light, an object which blocks the path of the light and the surface to form the shadow. So in this activity, what we have done, we have light up a torch and place an opaque object, say a book or a cardboard, anything that does not allow the light to pass through it, and a surface behind the object to form the shadow. So now see what happens, how shadows are formed. A shadow is formed when something blocks the path of the light. As you all know that the opaque object does not allow light to pass through it, so it blocks the path of the light. So the area behind the opaque object, say cardboard, does not get any light and so remains dark. This dark area is the shadow of the object. So you can see, you have seen many times that a shadow is always of black color. Whatever is the color of the object, the shadow will always be of the black color. So I hope now you are able to understand that how shadows are formed. So now we are going to discuss about the size of the shadow. Dear students, to determine the size of the shadow, you can stand in the sun once in the morning and then in the afternoon and then in the evening and look at the shadow on the ground. You will find the change in the size of the shadow, because the size of the shadow depends upon the position of the sun. Shadows are of different shape and size. In the morning, you observe that your shadow is of big size. In the afternoon, your shadow is smaller in size, but as the sun sets, the shadow size keeps on increasing. So this is how the size of the shadow changes in size. The size of the shadow changes because of the position of the sun. Dear students, size of the shadow also depends on the distance between the source of the light and the object. For understanding this point, let us perform an activity. Make your sibling stand in front of the wall of the dark room and you place a torchlight on him. Now what you will observe, that if your sibling, once you put the torchlight, you will find the size of the shadow, that this is the size of the shadow. And ask your sibling to come closer to you. Now see, in this picture, you ask your sibling to come closer to you, what you will find? You will find that the size of the shadow increases. The size of the shadow is bigger. So similarly, if you ask your sister or brother to go back, you will find that the size of the shadow is decreases. It means what you have done in this activity, what is the conclusion of this activity? The conclusion of this activity is that when the distance between the source of the light and the object is more, the size of the shadow is smaller. जितना ज़्यादा डिस्टेंस होगा बेटा, उतना साइज जो होगा शेडो का वो स्मॉल होगा. और जैसे जैसे हम डिस्टेंस को कम करते रहेंगे, व्हेन द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द सोर्स ऑफ द लाइट एंड द ऑब्जेक्ट इज लेस, द साइज ऑफ द शेडो इज बिगर. सो आई होप इट्स क्लियर टू यू दैट साइज ऑफ द शेडो, हाउ द साइज ऑफ द शेडो चेंजेस विद द चेंज इन द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द ऑब्जेक्ट एंड द सोर्स ऑफ लाइट. Now the next topic is eclipses. Eclipses, as you all know that sun is the source of light and earth and moon are not the sources of light. But how eclipses occur? So what do you think, when sunlight falls on earth and moon, do they cast shadows? Can we see these shadows? Yes, we can. The eclipses of the sun and the moon occur because of the shadow cast by the moon and earth respectively. When the sun or moon has an eclipse, its bright surface turns dark. What is the meaning of this, beta? Eclipses kab hote hain? When sun, earth and moon comes in a straight line. as you all know that Earth revolves around the Sun, Moon revolves around the Earth. So when they three come in the same line, then eclipses occur because Sun is the source of light, Earth and Moon are non-luminous bodies. But when Earth comes in between the Moon and Sun, then Earth does not allow the sunlight to fall on the Moon. Similarly, when Moon comes in between the Sun and Earth, then Moon does not allow the sunlight to fall on the Moon and cast its shadow. So this is how eclipses occur. There are two types of eclipses, solar eclipse and lunar eclipse. Now beta, let us study about solar eclipse. Solar eclipse happens, eclipse word hi beta isliye hai. Solar eclipse ka matlab hota hai ki us din hamein sun nazar nahi aata. Solar means the sun disappears. Okay, a solar eclipse occurs when the moon comes between the sun and the earth. रेवोल्यूशन कर रहे हैं मून एंड अर्थ. एक टाइम ऐसा आएगा जब ये तीनों स्ट्रेट लाइन में आ जाएंगे और उस दिन इक्लिप्स होगा. अब इक्लिप्स जब होगा तो व्हेन मून कम्स इन बिटवीन द सन एंड अर्थ, देन व्हाट काइंड ऑफ इक्लिप्स अकर्स? सोलर इक्लिप्स अकर्स. देन व्हाट हैपेंस? देन द शेडो ऑफ द मून फॉल्स ऑन द अर्थ. शेडो जो है मून की वो अर्थ पर आ जाएगी एंड इट डज नॉट अलाउ अस टू सी द सन. हमें सन नजर नहीं आएगा एंड दिस इज हाउ सोलर इक्लिप्स अकर्स. सो द शेडो ऑफ द मून फॉल्स ऑन ए पोर्शन ऑफ द अर्थ, सो द पीपल फ्रॉम दैट पार्ट ऑफ द अर्थ कांट सी द सन एंड वी हैव अ टोटल सोलर इक्लिप्स इन दीज पार्ट्स. और उस जगह पर क्या हो जाएगा? टोटल सोलर इक्लिप्स. देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ इक्लिप्सिस, टोटल सोलर इक्लिप्स एंड पार्शल सोलर इक्लिप्सिस. तो टोटल सोलर इक्लिप्स कब होगा बेटा? जहाँ पर हमें सन, जिन एरियाज पे सन नजर नहीं आएगा, दोज एरियाज आर हैविंग द टोटल सोलर इक्लिप्स. बट इन सम पार्ट्स ऑफ द अर्थ ओनली अ पार्ट ऑफ द सन कैन बी सीन. वी कैन सी ओनली अ पार्ट ऑफ द सन, सो दैट इज पार्शियल सोलर इक्लिप्स. आई होप इट्स क्लियर टू ऑल ऑफ यू अबाउट द सोलर इक्लिप्स. आई एम टेलिंग यू अगेन, सो लिसन केयरफुली स्टूडेंट्स, दैट solar eclipse occurs when the moon comes between the sun and the earth and it occurs on new moon day. And what happens in the solar eclipse? When moon comes in between the sun and earth, it does not allow, it casts its shadow on the earth and does not allow us to see the, and does not, the shadow of the moon falls on a portion of the earth and the people from that part of the earth are not able to see the sun. So this is how solar eclipse occurs. I hope it's clear to you. Now let us learn about the lunar eclipse. See beta, this is a diagram of lunar eclipse. What is the difference between these two diagrams? If you have observed carefully that in solar eclipse, moon is between the sun and the earth, and in lunar eclipse, earth is between the sun and the moon. So when earth comes between the sun and the moon, then what happens? Then lunar eclipse occurs and we are, thus the shadow of the earth falls on the moon. Earth ki shadow moon par aa jayegi and we are not able to see the moon on that particular night. So this kind of eclipse is known as lunar eclipse. It occurs on full moon night. Lunar eclipse hota hai jis din full moon night hoti hai, aur in Hindi we call it purnmashi. जिस दिन पूरा मून दिखाई देता है उस दिन हम बोलते हैं कि लूनर इक्लिप्स उस दिन होता है, बिकॉज पूरा मून आना था बट वी आर नॉट एबल टू सी द मून. सो व्हाट हैपेंस विद दिस इज नोन एज लूनर इक्लिप्स. तो जब अर्थ की शेडो ने मून को कम्प्लीटली कवर करा है, देन इट इज़ नोन एज टोटल लूनर इक्लिप्स. इफ इट कवर्स द मून पार्शियली, देन इट इज़ नोन एज पार्शियल लूनर eclipse. So students, I hope it's clear to you about the lunar eclipse and solar eclipse. I'm again telling you a brief a summary of these two eclipses. Solar eclipse occurs when the moon comes between the sun and the earth. Lunar eclipse occurs when the earth comes between the sun and the moon. जिस दिन solar eclipse होगा उस दिन अर्थ जो है, मून जो है वो अर्थ पर अपनी शेडो डाल देगा जिससे हमें सन नज़र नहीं आएगा, और सोलर इक्लिप्स पे अर्थ जो है वो मून पर अपनी शेडो डाल देगी जिससे हमें मून नज़र नहीं आएगा. Solar eclipse occurs on new moon day and lunar eclipse occurs on full moon night. And beta, these two diagrams are very, very important. We will do these two diagrams in the next class. I will show you how to make these diagrams. So, but before that, you have to learn these, you have to understand these types of eclipses. So, thank you and have a nice day.